Hello everyone, if you remember in August of last year, new malware surfaced that was very reminiscent of malware from the past. In this case, it was a Trojan that was uploaded to FOSS Hub that pretended to be classic shell in Audacity, which ended up overwriting your master boot record with a silly message. Today, the same sort of thing happened, in that a new email worm surfaced, spreading over Gmail, utilizing some interesting social engineering to get its victims to click on the link, infect themselves, and further spread the infection. Now, unfortunately, I can't show you this in action because from the time it surfaced to the time that it was detected and patched by Google only took a couple of hours, which is pretty incredible, so kudos to Google for their quick turnaround time, but I can show you what took place, what the emails looked like, and how it worked. Basically, an email arrives in your inbox with a subject stating that one of your contacts has shared a Google Docs document with you and includes a link in the email to a reasonable looking page. Once clicked, it asks you to choose your Google account, which is on the official Google account selection page, and then once past that asks you to grant permission to the Google Docs app, and this is the phishing application and not the real Google Docs service because you never have to give permission to Google Docs in order to access it. If you grant permission to this, which includes the ability to read, send, and delete emails from your account, it then mass mails itself to every Gmail contact it can find as a BCC, and the email itself is sent to the address hhhhh@mailinator.com. Now, we can check this, but unfortunately, usually whatever they're using to monitor this keeps it empty pretty much all the time. Occasionally, you'll see one or two emails in here from people trying to email this address, asking what's going on, but most of the time, you just see that the inbox is empty. And since you allow access to the worm, it bypasses any two-factor authentication that may be on your account, which just gives it free rein to read and delete and do whatever it wants to your emails. It's pretty interesting to see the steps that Google has taken to actually subvert this worm. When I first found out about it, Google had already implemented their fixes, so that's why I unfortunately cannot show you this worm in action. However, I was at work and forwarded the email containing a copy of the malicious URL here. We can see here on my mobile email that it replaced the little avatar section of the email with a fish hook to indicate that this is probably a phishing email. And on my actual email address on the computer, included a big bold message telling me to be wary of anything going on in this email. So what about the payload? Stuff like love letter from 2000 overwrote files and wreaked havoc across the globe. So what about this? Well, so far it's only mass mailed itself to your contacts. However, since it has access to your emails, it could perform password reset on services attached to that email, snoop on your private life, and all sorts of other malicious activities. If you got hit by this, it's time to do some serious upgrades on your security and be on the lookout for strange things happening to your accounts. On myaccount.google.com/permissions, you can remove any permissions that you might have given to this worm, and once that's gone, it won't be able to access your email anymore, but there's nothing saying that they haven't already downloaded everything that they had access to when they were granted access to your account. So probably the most important thing to do would be to change any passwords that were linked to your email address and maybe change your two-factor authentication settings or maybe even password manager settings. And that's about it for the new Gmail email worm. Sorry I couldn't really show you it in action, but I hope this video was informative and gave you sort of an overview of what happened with the situation. Thanks for watching. Take care. And remember, please don't kindly check the attached Google Docs file coming from me.